supply. Lord, I praise you and I lift you high. I will sing hallelujah, oh Lord. It seemed like a peaceful time, no disease was in the air. Disciples crowded round with 5,000 people there. And Jesus, while he was speaking, exuded in power. The Lord commanded attention, no matter day nor the hour. Our Savior taught in the lessons that we continue today. The world was learning that in the future we will be okay. Many believed and they were certainly on the right path. But there were a few that doubted and tried to challenge his math. 5 loaves of bread and he fed them all. 2 fish was enough. We believe that's blasphemy involved. That just don't add up. This man is going against all that we tell to the people. We need to think up a plan. There was no hiding the evil. Then the disciples and Jesus together went to have dinner. Then Jesus said, I will be betrayed by someone that is in here. Though shocked from all of them, Jesus declared, I say unto thee, the bread and wine and its symbol do in remembrance of me.
I will sing hallelujah. I will sing, oh Lord, I will sing hallelujah, oh Lord, for you are the source of my supply. Lord, I praise you and I lift you high. I will sing hallelujah, oh Lord.
The ultimate sacrifice began at Garden of Gethsemane. While Jesus was praying, approaching him was the enemy. What he had to do next was difficult even for him. But thy will be done, as Judas' betrayal signaled the end. He got arrested and tested, lumped in with murderers and thieves. Telling the truth got him lashed. Who can take this burden with ease? Beaten till his body was deformed and with shortness of breath. The crowd then convinced the pilot that he should be put to death. With that, the soldiers, they mocked and spit on him. Took off his clothes, put on him a scarlet robe and crown made from thorns of a rose. They made our Lord bear his own cross as he limped to the place he would be crucified. There will never be sadder a day. For 6 hours, Jesus hung there in agony as he cried. Had holes in his hands and feet, they even pierced them in his side. If he wanted, he could have got down from that cross with his power. But his love for us conquered all as he took his last bow. Earthly breath was taken, Jesus went to glory. What's said of what happened next will go down in all of his story. The temple veil torn into the spirits ascending, the earthquakes, the sky darkening from the sacrifice of the Most High. His body was taken to a tomb and sealed off with a stone, intentionally so it could never be opened alone. The priests, they wanted to make sure that there were no more tricks. They were confident that such a Messiah didn't exist. 3 days later, the impossible happened. Stone rolled aside, tomb was empty, never any sign that someone here had died. Jesus had risen, all of the power and more in his hands. After that, no need to question if he is the great I am. Because of his sacrifice, we can go on home to the Lord. Since he paid the largest price, all we need we can afford. So as long as there is breath in my body, you I will praise. Because at the Calvary, it was my soul that you did raise.
I will sing hallelujah, I will sing, oh Lord, I will sing hallelujah, oh Lord, for you are the source of my supply. Lord, I praise you and I lift you high. I will sing hallelujah, oh Lord. loaves.